your hand in the hand of the man called the sea. Take a look at yourself. You can look at others differently by putting your hand in the hand of the man from Galilee. Every time I look into the holy book, I want to tremble. When I read about the part where the carpenter cleaned the temple, for the buyers and the sellers, no different fellas than what I'm professing to be. And it causes me pain to know I'm not the guy that I should be. So put your hand in the hand of the man who stilled the water. Put your hand in the hand of the man who calmed the sea. Take a look at yourself. You can look at others differently by putting your hand in the hand of the man of Galilee. Mama taught me how to pray before I reached the age of 7. When I'm down on my knees, that's when I'm close to heaven. Daddy lived his life, the 2 kids, a wife, and you do what you must do. But he showed me enough of what it takes just to get you through. So put your hand in the hand of the man who stilled the water. Put your hand in the hand of the man called the sea. Take a look at yourself. You can look at others differently by putting your hand in the hand of the man of Galilee.
Good morning. Welcome to worship this morning as we gather. Together we give thanks to God for the gifts of this whole creation and each other and our Lord Jesus Christ. Let's begin with our gathering song number 746 in the Blue Book.
Day by day, your mercy.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
You are the treasured people of the Lord.
A people holy to the Lord our God.
Keep the words of the Lord in your heart. Teach them to your children. Talk about them when you are at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you rise. One does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. Again, the Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, increase in us your gift of faith, that forsaking what lies behind and reaching out to what lies ahead, we may follow the way of your commandments and receive the crown of everlasting joy. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The first lesson is from Revelations chapter 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show his servants what must soon take place. He made it known by sending his angel to his servant John, who testified to the word of God and to the testimony of Jesus Christ, even to all that he saw. Blessed is the one who reads aloud the words of the prophecy. And blessed are those who hear written in it. The time is near. I, John, your brother, who share with you in Jesus the persecution and the freedom and the patient endurance, was on the island called Patmos because of the word of God and the testimony of Jesus. It's in the spirit of the Lord's God. And I heard behind him a loud trump, like a trumpet saying, write in a book what you see and send it to the seven churches in Ephesus, to Simnon, to Pergamum, to Thyatira, to Sardis, to Philadelphia, and to Laodicea. Proverbs chapter 3. My child, do not let these escape from your sight. Keep sound wisdom and prudence, and they will be life for your soul and adornment for your neck. Then you will walk on your way securely, and your foot will not stumble. If you sit down, you will not be afraid. When you lie down, your sleep will be sweet. Do not be afraid of sudden panic, or of the storm that strikes the wicked, for the Lord will be your confidence and will keep your foot from being caught. Here ends the readings.
Precious Lord, take my hand.
Our gospel lesson this morning comes from the book of John, chapter 15, verses 18 through 21. Jesus said, "If the world hates you, keep in mind that it hated me first. If you belonged to the world, it would love you as its own. As it is, you do not belong to the world, but I have chosen you out of the world. That is why the world hates you. Remember what I told you. A servant is not greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will persecute you also. If they obeyed my teaching, they will obey yours also. They will treat you this way because of my name, for they do not know the one who sent me." This is the gospel of the Lord. Please be seated, and I invite the children who are here to come forward at this time. Good morning. You want it? Isn't it? Yeah, that's what we said, isn't it? Here, let me give this to you.
There we go. So how's school going? Not a lot of excitement there. I was expecting a lot of excitement. I don't know.
You've had 3 days of school so far.
Well, I want to tell you, we don't know what it's like to be bullied, not for loving Jesus. You know, a lot of people in the Bible were bullied because they were worshipers of Jesus. But bullying is never okay. The Bible says we should love our neighbor as we love ourselves. And we should treat other people the way we wish to be treated. Everyone, no matter what they look like or how they act, is a beloved child of God. The person being bullied and the bully. Jesus doesn't want us to ignore when someone's being picked on. You can tell a teacher or your parents when you see someone being bullied. You can stand with them or comfort them. What can you do when you are the one being picked on? I've asked two of our puppet friends, Belinda and Abby, to help us out. Good morning, girls. They are going to act out some little stories, and you can tell me when they're being bullies.
You are so stupid.
Is she being a bully? Yeah. Belinda, how would you answer that?
No, I'm not. I'm going to pray for you.
And here's another example.
Your family is so dumb. You should all go back to where you came from.
Bully? Yeah. Abby, how would you respond to that?
You need to stop talking to me like that. I've been praying for you.
Good response. Next.
Fatty Fatty 2x4 can't fit through the kitchen door.
I'm going to yell stop as loud as I can, then turn and walk away.
Sometimes the best reaction is just to walk away. The bully looks for your response, for your tears or your cries for help. And fighting isn't a good idea because someone could get hurt. Remember that when Jesus looks at someone, he always sees a person he loves very much.
Should we say a prayer? All right, let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for being with us in our hearts because sometimes it's really hard to live in this world. And sometimes our days are really stressful. Ask that you would be with these children and with all of the people who are gathered here and all of the people in the world.
If you were with us last week, you will recognize that we began our scriptures, our opening the scriptures, with the same passage from Revelation, because for 3 weeks, starting last week, we're talking about the churches that John of Patmos wrote to while he was being martyred in prison or imprisoned on the island of Patmos. So today, last week we talked about being lukewarm, which is like just kind of gliding through the world, through life, and not really standing up for people, not really caring too much about what's going on. And if you see something that's wrong that you have some impact on, you just don't do it because, I don't want to get involved. I'm tired. Oh, I'm busy. I just don't want to. I just can't do it. And that's what the churches were like from Jesus' perspective last week when we talked. And he was like, you're lukewarm. And I really want to just spit you out of my mouth. But today we're talking about the churches who are staying faithful, who are preaching and teaching and living the gospel and the good news in environments that don't want to hear it. And Nina talked to the children about how we don't know what it's like to be bullied for our faith. I mean, as a general rule, we get to go through our days doing the things that we do, living out the gospel, being faithful people of God, and nobody really bothers us about that. You know, they just kind of like, yeah, okay, yeah, believe, that's fine. It's good to have faith, or whatever the case may be. We just don't talk about it, right? We don't, and sometimes we do talk about it, but generally it's a good conversation. We don't understand what it means to be imprisoned, beaten, killed, because we believe that we are children of God. And that's what the two churches that we're going to talk about today are experiencing. This is from Revelation chapter 2 and 3, parts of each. To the angel of the church of Smyrna write this. These are the words of him who is the first and the last, who died and came to life again. I know your afflictions and your poverty, yet you are rich. I know about the slander of those who say they are Jews but are not, but are a synagogue of Satan. Do not be afraid of what you are about to suffer. I tell you, the devil will put some of you in prison to test you, and you will suffer persecution for 10 days. Be faithful, even to the point of death, and I will give you life as your victor's crown. Now whoever has ears, listen. Let them hear what the Spirit says to the churches. To the angel of the church in Philadelphia write this. These are the words of him who is holy and true, who holds the key of David. What he opens, no one can shut, and what he shuts, no one can open. I know your deeds. See, I have placed before you an open door that no one can shut. I know that you have little strength, yet you have kept my word and have not denied my name. I will make those who are of the synagogue of Satan, who claim to be Jews though they are not, but are liars, I will make them come and fall down at your feet and acknowledge that I have loved you. Since you have kept my command to endure patiently, I will also keep you from the hour of trial that is going to come on the whole world to test the inhabitants of the earth. This is the word of God according to the book of Revelation. Jesus knows and understands what it means to have to live in this world and yet live in the world of the kingdom of God at the same time. Jesus knows that because Jesus did that. And it was not a walk in the park. And we'd like to think that because Jesus is, God, and Jesus is the incarnate image of God, that Jesus didn't really have any trouble walking through this world because he automatically was wise enough to know what was going to happen and could escape from the clutches of different people. So, you know, Jesus must not have suffered, not the way we do anyway, right? But we forget, don't we? We forget that Jesus, the incarnate God in this world, was also at the same time human, just like you, just like me, just like all of our children and all of the people that God made, which is everything. Jesus experienced what it is to be human in this world that is full of sin and human ugliness. Do you remember one of the first stories in the book of Genesis after the creation story and Adam and Eve are kicked out of the garden and they have these two children called Cain and Abel? From the very beginning, there have been bullies, sibling rivalry, taken to the fullest extent when Cain and Abel decide that they can't both live in this world, and Cain kills Abel. Did I get that right? It's Cain who killed Abel, not Abel who killed Cain. One of the brothers is dead. And Jesus, God's mad, and blood is spilt, and it's not great. If you have ever been the target of somebody's anger or malice or spite or jealousy, then you have a glimpse of what it means to be part, live in this world of sin and at the same time live as a child of God. It is not easy. We don't die. Our blood isn't shed because of our faith, but we understand how easily it could become that kind of a thing in our small world. And we can understand how it already is a part of some people's world around, some part of their life around the world, because we do see it. My niece and her husband are missionaries. Okay. They live somewhere else, and they live in a place where they can't speak the gospel of the Lord in public, or they're arrested, or they're sent back, or something bad happens to them. And if they can't speak out loud the gospel of the Lord, then they talk to people who can't speak out loud the gospel of the Lord. It's all under the radar. We don't have that problem. We can speak good news. We can talk about Jesus. We can say, God bless you, and mean it. I was speaking to a woman, this was a very long time ago, when our children were little, who was struggling with their early teenage child. Might have been a preteen, I don't remember. And she was anxious and almost to the point of tears when she said, I don't know how to raise this child in this world. Because he was having trouble being a youth in this world, full of video games, and cell phones and computers and all of the things that we now have access to that we can't always monitor as closely as we'd like. And I remember our conversation went kind of in the way of, well, you know, we do live in this world, and as parents, it's our job to help our children learn how to be part of this world, but at the same time be part of the kingdom of God. That's our job. We're not going to be able to protect our children or ourselves or our neighbors from what happens here in in this world. They're going to be bombarded. We are all bombarded with what we should look like and what we should drive and what we should wear and what we should eat and what we should do and what we should have. And it's really easy to get caught up in that because we are easily distracted from what it is that God is asking of us, which is simply love God, love your neighbor, love yourself. God's teaching most of the time does not reconcile with the teaching of the world. And so we are caught as children of God right here in the middle. We pray. We pray daily, sometimes every minute, that our faith might be strong enough to withstand whatever it is that our bully, whoever that is, throws at us. But we also pray for that person, that country, that leader, that world, which we have no control over. We pray for that person, that thing, that bully, that God may be in their heart, that God may pull them into a different path, and that God may open their eyes, that we might love them as God has commanded. Jesus tells the two churches that he is with them, which is the ultimate promise. That no matter what they endure, no matter what happens, that Jesus will ultimately give us life, give us a victor's crown. That God will keep us from the hour of trial that is coming into the world. Now, Revelation is an interesting book, and we could sit here and talk about it for hours, but I just don't want to, because there's so many ideas and opinions, and there's so many things, people of the world who have decided that they know what Revelation means, when we can honestly say to each other, if we are children of God, that God does not open our eyes to understand everything, or sometimes anything, about a prophecy or a revelation. So we hang on to these words from the book of Revelation. I will keep you from the hour of trial. That's what Jesus says. The promise of God through Jesus Christ comes to us and stays with us no matter what, no matter where, no matter when. So it is my prayer for all of us that whatever happens this week, and goodness knows that things are happening pretty fast these days, both personally and in our world, that whatever comes, that you would remember that you have been given the gift of faith, you have been claimed and called, and you, through the power of the Holy Spirit, can stand up and say, I'm a child of God. In his name we pray. Amen. Will you please join in singing our hymn of the day? There is a Balm in Gilead on page 737 in the Blue Book.
Thank you.
in Christ, we have heard the word of truth, the gospel of our salvation. We believe in him and are marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us build ourselves up on our most holy faith. Pray in the Holy Spirit. Let us keep ourselves in the love of God. Look forward to the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ. If anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. Behold, everything has become new. God has given us the ministry of reconciliation. Therefore, let us be reconciled to God and to one another. Gracious God, have mercy on us. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. Uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us all our sin, through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen. We'll receive our offering at this time, and if there are children here who would like to share their offering with the children in Haiti, they're welcome to come up at this time. Our offertory song is number 759 in the Blue Book.
What shall I give to you? What shall I give to you? Oh, that we could give like the rain, pouring out the rich and for the same. Oh, that we could give like the sun, shining light on everyone. What shall I give to you? What shall I give?
Let us pray. God, our Creator, we open wide our hands and satisfy the desires of every living creature. With these gifts, we bless you for your tender nurture and care. Help us to delight in your will and walk in your ways through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Challenged by God's word in Christ, let us pray for the church, the world, and the whole creation. Compassionate God, embolden the church to seek all who are abandoned, clothe those who are naked, and mend what is broken. May we be generous bearers of your eternal love, God of grace. Hear our prayer. Sustaining God, we pray for farmers, field workers, and those who process crops. Keep us mindful of threats to the nourishing food that feeds the world, God of grace. Hear our prayer. Steadfast God, inspire world leaders to share resources and work collectively to end global poverty, starvation, and preventable diseases. Direct us to seek justice and equity that all may live in peace. God of grace, hear our prayer. Loving God, we pray for those who are afflicted, tormented, grieving, oppressed, and lonely, especially those we name in our hearts today. Deliver the strength of your love and compassion to all who need it today. God of grace, hear our prayer. Ever-living God, we rejoice to be heirs of the eternal life made real in Jesus' death and resurrection. We give thanks for saints of all times and places, first and last, who still inspire us to living faith. God of grace, hear our prayer. Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in the saving grace you freely give, now and forever. Amen. We are gathered together as one family through Jesus Christ, so let us pray boldly the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now may the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ fill you with every spiritual blessing. Amen. May the God of faithfulness and encouragement grant you to live in harmony with one another in accordance with Christ Jesus. Amen. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Just five more minutes, you thing. There we go. We received information or news last night that Royce Hansen passed yesterday afternoon, early evening. I would ask that you would please keep in your prayers Laurel and their daughter Lisa and her husband Brent. I would also ask that you would continue to keep Laurel in your prayers as well for peace and comfort. She continues to grow weaker, and so far she's still been able to stay at home because we've had enough help, but we are looking for people who are willing to come and stay with Laurel and provide care and the things that she needs. She is too weak to do some of the things that need to be done by herself. So if you know of anybody or are interested, please let me know. It is our goal to help Laurel stay at home, which is her goal. But we are not going to be able to do that unless we have enough people to do the care. So please let me know if you know of anybody. The date for the fall festival has been changed to September 15th instead of September 8th, because that will give us another week to do some preparation, to sign up for helping, and to sign up for donating fruits and vegetables and desserts and all sorts of that good stuff, and to get the meal ready, and for us to fill in the little paper that says we're going to contribute this part of our gifts and talents to the congregation. And everybody has a gift and a talent. Everybody. Because that's what God does. He gives us gifts and talents. And when, even if we don't think we do, we do. So if you don't know for sure what your gift or talent is, you should call me, because I can tell you. Kay says there's sign-up sheets in the bulletin board, and if you have any questions about what needs to be done, Kay and Jeannie are right there, and Jody's right there, and we, you know, we're more than happy to help. So that means that Sunday school will start on September 22nd instead of September 15th, but the Wednesday activities will stay as scheduled. It will start on September 11th. We have been gifted a box of salt and pepper shakers from Bev's cousin, who manages the restaurant Dino's, correct? So if you want some salt and pepper shakers, if you need to replace the ones that you have at home, or you just need some extras, go ahead and help yourself. And Bev, say thank you to your cousin for us. Are there any other announcements or prayers and concerns? Yes.
I just wanted to remind people, today is the last event at Paradise Farm. That's the Loosemore Farm. They're having music and food and lots of activities for family fun. So that starts at 4:30.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. Will you please pray for Angie, Honora's mom? She is not feeling well. She fell last week and is recovering, but she doesn't feel good. So please pray for healing for Angie. Any other prayer concerns, Joys? Kay's daughter, Sarah, is going to Mayo this coming week to do some tests to find out what direction to go with treating the cancer that has returned. So please pray for Sarah, for Kay, for their whole family, as they need strength and healing and the things that will make things better. The children who are here, come forward and help me, please. Oh, wait. I remember. The children need to come forward, because I have a gift for you. And all of the people who are part of the school here, which is like some of you and Tina and, yep. And are there any other, see now Ty and... Ty's sister, Taylor, and, well, you're going to school too, right? Yeah, are you going back to college? Well, you should come up. I think I have enough. Come on. And Palmer should come up, even though she's not going to school, because I have a treat for her too. We're going to say blessings, all right? We're going to say blessings. But before we do that, I'm going to give you some gifts. And there's lots of you, so you're going to have to be a little patient. Can I scooch over between you, okay? All right, so Nina, our person over there who does children's sermons, who is wonderful, and she loves you guys just as much as all of the rest of us do. We sat one Friday morning, or two Friday mornings, and made bags. We made bags, and we filled them with treats, And we said to ourselves, let's give these to the children who are returning to school. So I'm going to start handing them out. Now, I know that some of you are older and you won't find as much use out of them as maybe some of the younger children, but they're still kind of fun. Now, there should be something in here that's useful, something in here that's fun, something in here that will remind you that you are a child of God, so that when the day is not going just right, you can stand up and say, no, I am a child of God. Leave me alone. And I love you. And I will pray for you. Because that's how we do it, right? If somebody is picking on us, if something is not going right, we remember that we are children of God. Is that the right one? Okay. Yeah. So, oh, Palmer, I'm so glad you're here. Now, we also decided that just because they weren't children, but they need blessings just as much as the rest of us, we made some bags for your teachers and for your teachers. Where did Tina go? And that one. And for Mr. Oland, who takes, you know, who takes care of you and does lots of stuff. And we made bags for your the people who clean your school so that you don't have to. But you really got to help them out, right? What's the best way to help Tina clean the school? Don't make a mess. Got it? All right. I'll check in with Tina and see how that's going. Now, the other thing I have is something for Palmer, because it's important for Palmer to know, I'm going to sneak right back there, that even though she isn't starting school yet, even though I think she should, because you don't look to me, I mean, it seems to me you should go to school, but you're not quite there yet. So I'm going to let you pick. These are little lip balm toys. Can you hold that for me, honey? Thank you. See what you do? You open it up. Put that on your lips when your lips are dry or when you feel like being pretty, which you are. Which one would you like? You got whales and I don't know what that is, a unicorn fish, a narwhal. That looks like a camel to me. This looks like a whale tail. You pick. Ah, good choice. All right. We're going to do blessings, okay? So let's pray. Gracious God, you have gifted to us, most importantly, the gift of faith through your Holy Spirit, so that we can, no matter what happens or where we are, we can stand firm in your strength and know that we are your child and that you will protect us and that no matter what, you love us. Help us to see in each other's eyes this gift of love that you give us. Help us to remember that nobody that we meet isn't already blessed by you, isn't already given the gift of love, and isn't already your child. So let us live in grace and peace. I ask that you would be with these students, with their teachers and their administrators and all of those who have any contact with these children. Keep them safe. Give them strength. Remind them that the gifts that they have to teach and to guide and to care for come from you and should be used well. Be with the people who surround them with love, the people of this congregation, the people of this community. Keep our hearts clean and clear. Forgive us when we sin. Show us mercy and teach us how to do the same thing with everybody we run into. We pray these things in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, and all God's children said. All God's children said.
Amen.
All God's children said.
Amen. Amen.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Adults, you can stay if you want to, because we're going to share the peace. Oh, look, they're running away. What is that about? All right, you guys, you know what to do. All right? Hands out straight. Don't hit anybody. All right? Ready? Right here. Can you do it with me? You want to help? Okay, just, you can, that's fine. Arms out. The peace of the Lord.
Peace of the Lord.
Be with you all.
Be with you all.
And also with you.
Please go share some peace with each other. Peace be with you. So please continue, remain standing, and we will sing our sending song together. And if you want to know what the right page is, I will let you know it is not 759, it is 776. Be thou my vision. Please join in singing that song with us. Go in peace, remember the poor, and know that Jesus loves you. Thanks be to God.